أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Like always, we start by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we send as much peace and blessings as we can upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every Tuesday we learn and we try to extract the main topic and the main theme of every surah in the Quran and every chapter. And alhamdulillah, we have reached the seventh chapter, Surat Al-Alaaraf. And we've talked last week about one of the topics of Surat Al-Alaaraf, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the people of Al-Alaaraf. وَذَكَرْنَا يَا أَحْبَابِ فِي الْأُسْبُوعَ الْمَاضِي أَنَّ أَصْحَابِ الْأَعْرَافِ هُمْ قَوْمٌ إِسْتَوَتْ حَسَدَاتُهُمْ مَعَ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ فَكَانُوا يَقِفُونَ أَوْ مَحْبُوسِينَ عَلَى مُرْتَفَعٍ وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُعْرَبُ بكلمة الْأَعْرَافِ لأن كلمة عُرْف كل مرتفع عن الأرض في لغة العرب إلى أن يفصل الله سبحانه وتعالى في أمرهم وتكلمنا في هذا بالتفصيل. If you want, inshallah, to get the meaning and the point of the people of Al-Arab, please get back to last week lecture. Today, inshallah, also we have so many topics and so many things we need to learn from Surat Al-A'raf. We start by this verse, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى يا بني آدم لا يفتننكم الشيطان كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة إلى آخر الآية الكريمة. O son or children of Adam, يا بني آدم, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling upon us, do not let shaitan deceive you as he tempted your parents, Adam and Eve, out of paradise. Because of what? Because of the whispering of shaitan, because of the tricks of shaitan. That's why you always see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a reminder in a different positions of Quran, do not ever follow the steps and the tricks of shaitan. Otherwise, you will end up in a disaster. Because the purpose and the goal of shaitan in this life is to get people distracted and to, you know, make them lose every benefit in this life. And accordingly, they will be in a bad situation on the Day of Judgment. That's why this is a reminder from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take the lesson and learn the lesson from what happened to your, you know, very great parents, Adam and Hawa alayhim as-salam. And do not even listen to shaitan and do not follow these steps of shaitan. This is a reminder from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ومن الآيات أيضا التي وردت في هذه السورة نعرج على أبرز المواقف أو أبرز الآيات التي نحتاجها وإلا فكل آية في السورة الكريمة تحتاج إلى كلام وتحتاج إلى يعني أن يتعلم منها الإنسان. قال الله سبحانه وهذا مما نحتاجه في كل يوم يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling upon us in the same chapter, actually just like three verses after the verse that we've talked about right now. O children of Adam, dress properly at the time of worship. When you go to the masjid, the scholar says it's not just the building of the masjid, but at any time of worship, even if you pray at your house, you need also to dress properly. You cannot just dress some shorts and some, you know, tank tops and just, you know, pray because you are home. No, still you stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we have also to dress properly everywhere we pray. In the masjid, at home, anywhere you pray, dress properly and adorn yourself because you are standing and facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In your prayer, you are supplicating Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And exactly right after this, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. We really need to focus on this because this is a great problem. A thing that we actually fall into every single day, almost every day, we waste food and we waste drinks, and we, you know, sometimes we eat even more than our bodies need, or we waste food that just we throw it in the garbage. That's Allah Ta'ala al-Afiyya. Both are wrong. Whether we waste food in terms of throwing it into the garbage, this is actually a great mistake and a great sin. That's Allah an ya'fu anna. Or even when we just eat beyond our, you know, the need of our body, this could also be one of the ways how we waste and how we just, you know, misuse the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this body is amana, is a thing that you will be asked about on the Day of Judgment. That's why we have to take care of our bodies. If you cannot exercise, if you cannot, you know, do, you know, these exercises or workout, at least do not eat, you know, more than your body needs. Otherwise, it will cause a lot of diseases. And if you, you know, if you ask any physician, any doctor, what is the main reason and the main cause behind all of the diseases on the face of the earth, he will say, at a point in time, the food is the reason for the disease. Just the misuse of the food, or eating too much of the food, or, you know, exaggerating eating the sugar and this stuff, will cause in a lot of diseases. That's why we have to take care of this, because it's one thing that we will be actually asked about on the Day of Judgment if we do not take care of our own bodies. This is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. So one thing is never follow shaitan, or never let shaitan deceive you the way he did with Adam and Hawa alayhim as-salam. And number two, to dress properly when you pray your salah, when you get to the masjid, when you pray anywhere. And number three, eat and drink and enjoy the blessings of Allah, but never waste the food in any way, shape or form. And number four is this verse, اُدْعُوا رَبَّكُمْ تَضَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَةً إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. Supplicate, make dua, ask your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala secretly, and in a way that you show humbleness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But remember that He does not like those people who transgress in their dua, those people who exceed the limits. And I remember that during the month of Ramadan, we've talked about this verse. How do we, you know, exaggerate or exceed the limits when we make dua? Like some people might say, oh Allah, give me this wealth, or give me this job, or give me so and so, and they do not do the things that, you know, cause them to have or to acquire this wealth. يعني يا أحباب لا ينبغي ولا يليق بالمسلم أن يقول يا رب ارزقني مليون دولار في الصباح غدا. هذا سوء أدب مع الله سبحانه وتعالى. لأن هذا بأسبابنا البشرية لا يمكن أن الإنسان ينبغي أن يحصل على الرزق. وقلنا من قبل إن الله سبحانه وتعالى خلق الرزق وأوجب علينا أن نسعى لاكتساب هذا الرزق، لا أن يركن الإنسان أو أن يتواكل أو أن يدعو بشيء لا يسعى هو لتحقيقه. So when we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to make it logic. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most capable of everything. He gives you even beyond your imagination. But when we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you ask for forgiveness, for mercy, ask openly and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the highest level of paradise. But when we ask for the things in this dunya, we have to be careful in a way that we ask for things that we actually qualify to, that we can actually acquire it by our effort and depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the first place. So when we talk about the issue of rizq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the same chapter, Surat Al-Alaaraf, Surah number 7, وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمْ الْخَبَائِثِ. يعني النبي الكريم صلى الله عليه وسلم بوحي من رب العالمين أحل لنا الطيبات كل ما هو طيب وطاهر، وحرم علينا ماذا؟ الخبائث.
طيب لأن بعض الناس مثلا يقول إن الله سبحانه وتعالى حرم الخمر تحريما واضحا وحرم لحم الخنزير تحريما واضحا، لكن التدخين يعني ما فيش آية ولا حديث بتحرم التدخين. العلماء بيفهموا ويستنتجوا من آيات القرآن الكريم أمورا تقاس على بعضها. إذا سألت أي أحد حتى المدخن نفسه هل هذه السجارة أو التدخين شيء طيب ولا شيء خبيث؟ يعني طيب بلاش دي، يعني هل هو يضيع المال ولا يضيعه؟ طبعا بيضيع المال. يؤثر على الصحة سلبا ولا يؤثر؟ طبعا بيؤثر على الصحة. يبقى في أمرنا إهدار للمال الذي سيسأل عنه الإنسان يوم القيامة، وتبديد للصحة والعافية التي أيضا سيسأل عنها الإنسان يوم القيامة. فهذا إذن لا ينبغي، ويدخل تحت قول الله تعالى ويحرم عليهم الخبائث. So in our religion, the pure things, the things that benefit ourselves and benefit the communities are open and lawful, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear and lawful in Quran, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also taught us in the sunnah how to practice them. And on the other side, the things that harm us or waste our money, waste our time, waste our, you know, health is haram. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the Prophet that been sent to you, he will make it lawful for you, the pure and the good things, and he will make it prohibited for you, the impure or the things that does not benefit you. نسأل الله تعالى أن يعلمنا وإياكم ما ينفعنا وأن ينفعنا بما يعلمنا. وإن شاء الله تعالى بقي القليل في سورة الأعراف نستكمله معا في الأسبوع القادم. وجزاكم الله خيرا وسعيد بهذه الوجوه الطيبة، والتحقوا بنا كل يوم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.